our newest guest at Anime Fest, Ms. Atsuko Tanaka. Thank you very much for inviting me to Anime Fest this year.
ちょっと私のことも多分あんまりご存じないと思うので、アニメマニアの人が知らないうちに私の原画を編集して、YouTube に上げてくれたものがありますので、ちょっとそれをご覧ください。
Can you might mute the mics? They're howling. HDMI. So there's many of you that probably don't even know who I am, but there's actually some interesting folks out in the world who found several of my cutscenes that I've animated in different works and made a compilation film. So I've brought that with me, and I'd like to show it to you, so you kind of get a sense of some of the work that I've done. Are we not showing the screen yet, so... The other... Unplug the other sources other than HDMI, it's not finding you. As soon as we get a shot, no problem. Let me unplug and replug on my side. If this doesn't work in a minute or two, we'll just have you all gather really close and I'll turn on an iPad screen. I just unplugged. This is working in the other room.
Try playing the files. Sometimes they weren't registered until you start to plug.
You would see the iPad screen without doing anything if it works. I have a backup.
Oh,
just say sure.
So this is, that the work you just saw was Miyazaki Hayao's Meikante Holmes, Detective Holmes, I think is the word. And this is Mononoke Hime. These are all scenes that she has animated. So this is called Sugata Sanshiro. This is Tetsujin 28. And Lupin the Third, got Flood of the Fuma Clan.
Thank you.
So what we'd like to do is, she has two works that she'd like to show you some scenes on before she shows you some of what she brought from Japan with her. You're going to want the sound from this, but is that okay? So, when I worked on the Castle of Cagliostro, I had only become a key animator about a year previous. And so I was kind of a newbie, if you were, and I think I caused Mr. Miyazaki a lot of trouble. Alright, is it showing here? Go ahead, lower the volume a little bit. So we're going to do our best to skip to the right part, but we're going to go into the first one.
この文字は死滅したゴート文字だ。
ゴート文字？
光と影再び一つとなりて蘇らん。1517年、年号はローマ数字だ。
400年前の死亡か。
お待ちどうさま。
おお、うまそう。
湯船死ね、何見てるの？
いや、何、古い指輪拾ったもんでね、値打ち物かなって。
まあ、綺麗ね。これクラリス様の紋章よ。
クラリス。
この写真、子供の頃のだけど、昨日修道院から戻られたの。きっと素敵におなりだわ。
修道院？
あら、知らないの？お客さんたちもクラリス様と伯爵様の結婚式を見に来たのかと思ったわ。
あ、そうか。どうりで観光客多いと思った。
でもクラリス様かわいそう。伯爵ってね、有名な女からしなのよ。
おや、俺みたい。どう？
やっぱり伯爵の指だって。
指輪を見て目の色変えやがった。
この指と見ちゃったけど、指輪ももらいたい。
お前、昼間の娘が太后のお姫様だって知ってた
か？おーら、言わなかったっけ。 油断あり
Luca,
¿qué es eso? ¡Cuidado!
私を信じろ。指にはめてこっちへ来るんだ。
うちの足。
指輪が来るまで待てる。
So this particular work I remember well because it started in July and we only had 4 months to finish it because it had to debut in December for the Christmas season. So it was incredibly tight deadline-wise. So I calculated it out and I needed to finish 2 entire cuts each day in order to make the deadline. So because I was a beginner, there were a lot of, let's say, areas that needed touch-up or correction by Mr. Miyazaki, and he was kind enough to call me to his office every day. So he would point out, he'd say, hey, right here, this isn't good. He goes, okay, I'll go fix it. He goes, never mind, I'll do it myself. So I remember also because right after the project kicked off, I had the opportunity to go on a vacation to Europe. Well, she was invited to go to Europe, let's put it that way. Maybe not vacation so much, but she just started this work and there's no way you can leave the job, right? But she was able to discuss it and they decided that it would be a good educational experience to see the castles in Europe. For drawing this anime. And so he thought, you know, kind of my future, if you were, and he decided this could be a good educational lesson, actually, and so they permitted it. So, you know, it's kind of weird for me to say this, but I made plenty of mistakes. So we're going to try to change the output again. I don't know if this will create music. Can you mute it? Because I don't need to. Okay. know the shadows make it a little bit hard to see, but you see it's a picture of Lupin. She just drew this while you guys were watching. Because I was in such a rush to write it, I actually drew the bullet marks, the explosion marks here, on top of Clarice's body. But because they were different cell layers, I wasn't really paying attention to the bottom layer. So yeah, he still reminds me of this particular mistake every day. So you taught me several things. So he taught me many things, but specifically he talked about just the frontal view of a face. So when she was thinking about layout, she was asked to draw a close-up of a person, and so she drew it with the frame, the box being the visual picture frame of the TV, in such a manner. So she was taught that, you know, when she needed to draw this, it would be better, instead of cutting it where she had before, where she shows the top of the head, to cut it right above the eyebrows. It's just a better interpretation, intensity. Yeah, so the more distance you leave showing the top of the head to the top of the screen, the more gap that there is there, kind of the duller it looks. So if you wanted to draw somebody like spacing out or looking kind of dumb or stupid, then you can draw it like that with a gap at the top. But when you're trying to make them look cool, it's the other one. Yeah, so if you watch like just the framing on a Hollywood movie, for example, when they do close-ups of people, this is how they're framing the shot. So this is something I heard from Mr. Miyazaki pretty recently, actually. He says, you know, a lot of the new animators out there today, when they're drawing a layout, they all kind of do it the same way. And that always seems to look like it just looks like the same layout on an iPhone from the camera. So, you know, he kind of prefers that people would put a little more thought into the layout of the scene instead of just taking a picture with their iPhone and using that as a reference. The size of the lens, the angle of the lens, the, you know, all the characteristics tend to make everything look the same. Famous animator named Sugino, and Sugino Akio. Akio was his first name. And he was famous for drawing really cool, handsome looking guys. And so the way he would draw his eyes is similar to how I just drew it here on the paper here.
Miyazaki-san to 雑談をするときによく杉野さんはこういうふうに目を描くよねって
So Miyazaki-san would often, just in normal everyday conversation around the office, he would often bring up the fact that, hey, you know, Mr. Sugino, you know, he always dries the eyes like this. So when you... So for example, when you draw the eye and you make the iris kind of a really wacky shape like this and the pupil dark in the middle. And so I thought, and you know, he's talked about drawing eyes this way so much that when I was working on Cagliostro and I had to draw Princess Clarice close up, draw her eye close up, I thought, okay, I'll go ahead and enter some highlights and kind of make it look like this. So I thought that's what he wanted because he talked about it all the time. This is how they draw their eyes, right? So I drew it that way. But he got really angry. You made this anime look like a shoujo manga. So he keeps telling me, Tanaka, all you're good for is drawing shoujo manga style anime. Teasing her. So this is the corrected version of the actual cell he gave me from the production. So I asked for his signature, which he did give me, along with some extra commentary. So here I officially confirm that this is the keyframe animation of Atsuko Tanaka. So I probably drew the eyes like this, and that's what he got angry about, the little white highlights. So he said, hey, the chin, it's bad. It needs fixing. That's what he wrote in the comments. So this is maybe about 13 years ago she had it signed, which is many years after the production. So this is Enigata on the right, and his comment on the left says, I like this Enigata. So, you know, Miyazaki's self-portrait is the Porco Rosso. This is Clarice from what we just watched, right? Live on the Third Castle of Cagliostro. You know, looking at this now, I'm embarrassed, is what the comment says. Being alive is embarrassing. So basically he said, hey, I'm going. She just hurt her neck a little bit. So yeah, he says, yeah, I'm really busy right now, as a son, because he writes the comment, I'm really busy right now. So this is signed by Otsuka Yasuo, who was the animation director of that. He was the chief animation director of the first TV series of Lupin the Third. He's very famous for action scenes, especially car action scenes. But he wasn't exceptionally talented at drawing cute ladies. So he wasn't allowed to ever touch the character Clarice when they were making this film. So it says, this is, remember, this is Otsukayasuo's signature here. He signs this and he writes the comment, you know, I never did get Miyazaki to let me touch Clarice. I still remember. So there's one more she'd like to show in the Blu-ray. This cut with Clarice right here. So this is the scene where Clarice kind of comes back to her senses. So they didn't have a lot of time making this production, right? So there were a lot of scenes where they had to kind of make some trade-offs, and this is a particular scene in which they did that. Right, so this is when she came back to her senses after being injected with some poison or personality manipulation. So when she came back to her senses, one of the things we were trying to do was actually add a highlight to her eyes to give it some more clarity and depth. So even in the in-between animations, there's highlights written, drawn in there. But production finish didn't have time to deal with it, so they completely eliminated all of that work. So I asked Miyazaki-san when they were going to make a Blu-ray of this and do some retouch, I said, hey, you want to add those highlights back in? But he had some different scenes in mind that were more important to him personally. So, you know, there's a scene that comes up later in the film, and what they wanted to do was be able to have the water recede and the ruins of ancient Rome show. And he never had the time to go back and do that scene. That's what he wanted to do. But again, that's a massive addition to the work, so didn't happen. So we're going to switch to a different work now. Sorry?
You do want sound.
For this, we do want sound, yes. And I think my battery died on the camera. So I'll get a new one. Well, this is queuing up.
Who are you? A great
stop the player. Pull the cord. So this is the scene that you saw with May on top of Kodomo. And this is with the corrections of the chief animation director and also the sound. Try to flip through it here and see. There's a lot here. But each one you see where there's just like a little tiny face, that's a correction. To be honest with you, this was kind of a part-time job for me. I wasn't a full-time staffer at this time. I was an employee of a company called Telecom Animation Studios. So I was at that time I was the animation director for Winnie the Pooh. So after I started on that, then I learned of the Totoro project. So other than sleeping, all I did was draw those days. And eventually I ended up getting tendonitis. So, I mean, one of the people was the person who later went on to become animation director for Kiki's Delivery Service, Kondo Tatsuya-san. 達也、達也。あとは北野耕作、who did the Wind Rises and and also only yesterday.And also the animation director for Pompoko, Shinji Otsuka. So, is the animator drew the witches climbing the stairs in the house where he has to see? Even though all those people went on later to do great things, he interviewed them all and didn't accept any of them. So Otsuka Yasuo-san asked him, all these great people, but why? What are you thinking? And his answer was, the people that were hired had a different shine in their eyes. Nobody understood what they were talking about. So she has more she can keep talking about, but we're out of time. I don't want to delay the next panel anymore than we already have. But please, tomorrow and also Sunday, we'll be talking even more gossip about Ghibli. I mean, not gossip, stories about Ghibli in the works. So please join us again. Let's give a big thank you.